Ladies and gentlemen, there is no denying the popularity of Stone Cold Steve Austin. However, I think you all will agree that Stone Cold, as of late, has been getting away with murder. We've seen Stone Cold Steve Austin assault WWF officials. We've seen Stone Cold Steve Austin attack WWF announcers, including yours truly. However, last night, Stone Cold Steve Austin went too far. Because last night, Stone Cold Steve Austin endangered the lives of you WWF fans by driving his pickup truck all the way into the arena and all the way down to the ring. And then furthermore, used that pickup truck as a weapon against his opponents. Austin once again struck a referee, struck another WWF official. He gave him the stunner. Whether it was inadvertent or not, and just as that official was coming back around, can I have your attention? Just as that official was coming around, regaining his senses, he attempted to disqualify Stone Cold and give the match to Rocky Maivia when a second referee dove into the ring and counted Rocky's shoulders down for the 1, 2, 3. Therefore, tonight, live here on Raw, I am demanding that Stone Cold Steve Austin defend the Intercontinental Championship. Against the individual that some of you feel as though he is the people's champion, making reference to The Rock, right here tonight on Raw.
That's a surprise.
Certainly is, but I think perhaps the best decision. There's another surprise. He wasn't scheduled. The current Intercontinental Champion, Stone Cold.
You got something to say?
Let me see if I got this straight. With all the damn explosions going on back here, I thought you said you ordered Steve Austin to do something. Yeah. You shut up. You ought to understand right now, Stone Cold Steve Austin does what he wants when he wants. I don't give a rat's ass who you are, personally.
Well, I'll tell you who I am, all right?
Go ahead.
I'm the proud owner of the World Wrestling Federation, and furthermore, Mr. Austin, I'm your boss.
Look at the officials and agents surrounding the ring.
That didn't impress me one bit. And frankly, I don't give a damn.
Vince intelligently brought some backup out here.
Well, then let me make it a little clearer for you, all right? And you just might give a damn about the consequences if you don't defend the Intercontinental Championship here tonight.
Vince is standing up to him.
What would those consequences be, punk?
to get into that, all right?
Well, let me tell you something. You talk about your consequences, all this and that, like you're some kind of big shot. Stone Cold's got his own consequences. If anybody wants to see Vince McMahon get his ass whipped, give me a hell yeah. In case you didn't hear him, they said, oh, hell yeah.
I have something else I've been meaning to talk to you about, your language.
Damn it, Vince, you're right.
I said your language.
Hell, son, I'm trying to apologize. Jesus Christ, give me a chance. I'm telling you right now. Hold the damn microphone up. We ain't out here to talk about my language. What we're out here talking about is a set of consequences and me defending the Intercontinental Championship. I won the damn thing fair and square last night. I ain't gonna give you an answer right now. You're worried about your precious little ratings, about Stone Cold being in your ring. I'm gonna take my ass backstage. I'm gonna pop a top on a beer. I'll probably eat me a hot dog or two. And while you sweat it out and think about your consequences, I'll come out later in the show and give you an answer. But I'm telling you this, if Stone Cold comes back out, somebody's gonna get their ass whipped. It might be you, Jim Ross. It might be your precious little official in his striped shirt. And you can damn well bet your bottom dollar, son, it might be your sorry ass.
The Texas Rattlesnake is out of control. No one in the history of the World Wrestling Federation has ever driven a truck into a match and then used it as a weapon like he did last night at Degeneration X.
I think